Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture today. Now I would like to explain about a new instrument which is called as multiple toothed vulsellum. So this multiple toothed vulsellum, if you see the main, there is one more instrument which is similar to this one multiple toothed vulsellum, which is called as Alice forceps. So even Alice forceps that is similar to this multiple toothed vulsellum. Okay, so if you see the multiple tooth, so let me show you both these and I'll tell you the differences. So this is multiple tooth vulsellum, this is Alice forceps. If you see both these multiple tooth vulsellum and Alice forceps, they have a lock. Okay, and if you see the ends, the tips, these blades, they have teeth. Okay, the tip has many teeth. Even here they have teeth. Okay, the only difference is if you see, even here the blades are not opposing. But if you see here, the multiple tooth vulsellum, it is a little curved, the instrument. Here it is not curved. And this multiple tooth vulsellum is a little larger instrument when compared to Alice forceps. It is larger than Alice forceps. I don't say it is the largest instrument. It is larger than Alice forceps. Based on these two differences, you'll have to differentiate between Alice forceps and multiple tooth vulsellum. Now, why is this instrument curved? The curve of this instrument will correspond to the axis of vagina. The curve of this instrument will correspond to axis of the vagina. That is the reason why this instrument is curved. One, you'll have to see whether it has lock. So it has a lock and the blades are not opposing and the tip has teeth and the instrument is curved to correspond to the axis of vagina. Now, what are the uses of multiple tooth vulsellum? So the uses, there are obstetric uses and also gynecological uses. The obstetric uses of multiple tooth vulsellum includes, see, it has some tooth at the tip and as a result it is used to hold the structures. So obstetric uses include, it is used to hold the anterior lip of cervix in dilatation and evacuation operation and suction evacuation. The disadvantage is that if we use this in D&E, dilatation and evacuation, it produces trauma to soft and vascular cervix. As it produces trauma to soft and vascular cervix, we don't use this multiple tooth vulsellum. Instead, we can use Alice forceps for holding the anterior lip of cervix in dilatation and evacuation. Then gynecological uses include to hold the paracervical lip in anterior colporrhaphy or vaginal hysterectomy. It is also used to remove the polyp alternative to Lanes forceps. It is used to hold the fundus of the uterus in abdominal hysterectomy. So these are the different uses of this forceps, which is multiple tooth vulsellum, where it is mainly used to hold the structures because of the presence of its tooth. Okay, so this is multiple tooth vulsellum. Thank you for watching my lecture. Vulsellum.